probably talk about plugins for ChatGPT every single day. But I realized that I haven't really done a very basic overview of what plugins are and how to use them. So that's what I'm going to do today. All right. So before we get into it, let me just tell you what's up and who I am. My name is Jordan Wilson. I host Everyday AI. We're a daily live stream podcast and free daily newsletter helping everyday people learn and leverage AI. And we do free ChatGPT trainings twice a week. It's called Prime Prompt Polish, the PPP method. And I had one yesterday and people said, hey, these plugins sound great because we teach about plugins, but they're like, I need something more basic. So this video is for you. If you know a little bit about plugins, but you're not sure what they are, why you should use them or how. So this is the AI in 5. We do very quick tutorials. So let's do a very quick overview of what plugins are. So first, you're going to need a ChatGPT Plus account, okay? It is $20 a month. Here's the thing. You're not paying for it. Start paying for it like yesterday, all right? I'm not paid by OpenAI to say that, but it is the easiest $20 a month. I would easily spend hundreds of dollars a month just to have access to ChatGPT plugins, all right? So first, you have to have the paid account. Second, you need to enable plugins. So you go into your settings down here in the lower left-hand corner. You click on settings and beta. You click beta features, and then you have to toggle plugins on. And also there is advanced data analysis, formerly known as code interpreter. So we're going to be looking here at plugins. All right. So when you start a new chat, a lot of times it might still be over here on GPT 3.5. Don't start a chat there. Because once you start a chat in whatever mode you select, you are stuck there. So I, as an example, have four modes right now. I have GPT 3.5, which is the free mode. I have GPT 4 default. Then I have GPT 4 advanced data analysis. And then I have GPT 4 plugins. So when you start a new chat, and this is what we teach in the PPP course, you really have to think ahead on what your purpose is in this chat. Because the more you kind of train your chat, it's going to get smarter and it's going to produce better outputs for you. But you can't go back and say, oh, I'd like to use plugins now, right? All right. So let's go ahead. Let's jump in and look at plugins. So there are more than 1,000 plugins. So let's take a look of how these work. So again, you have to choose plugins. And then right here, it'll say add plugins, right? So I actually have to uninstall plugins all the time. And one thing that you'll find out pretty quickly is the plugin interface is a little wonky. So sometimes it is in alphabetical order, sometimes it's not. That's actually why I uninstall plugins all the time. So it's hard. The interface is clunky. Anyways, so what you're going to do is you're going to click on that and you're going to go to the very bottom. And this is where the plugin store is. Okay. And you'll be able to sort by popular, new, all, or installed. Okay. So if I click installed, these are all the ones that I currently have installed. Again, I uninstall them a lot because it gets, if I try a plugin once and if I don't like it, I just uninstall it because the interface, again, isn't that great. So you can really search for anything. So let's say you want to use ChatGPT for your personal life to help you travel and plan travel. So I can search. And here's all the different plugins that can help you with travel. And then you can use the pagination down here to find something, right? Or maybe you want something that can help you with your shopping as an example, right? So I can just type in shopping and you can go through and choose what you want. All right, so let me go and I'm gonna just find a new plugin. So I'm gonna go to popular here. Let's see what's popular. Let's see what's popular. I'm going to add a new one. Okay, this one here. Generate a map image based on provided location, tilt, and style. Cool. Let's do that. So I just installed the plugin. Okay. So now I have to, because you can only have three plugins enabled at any time. If I want to use that plugin, I have to find it. So again, start at the top. Sometimes it's in alphabetical order. Sometimes it's not. So I know because you only have three slots. And this says 3 of 3 enabled. So I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to unselect one. So I want to keep that one enabled. I'm going to unselect this one. And then let's go to find that Earth plugin. Okay, here we go, Earth. So when you start a new chat, I always say this, please tell me what the Earth plugin can do. Anytime, if you're new to plugins, go ahead, do what I just showed you. Find it, install it, and ask the plugin what it can do. All right, so it's telling me it can say generate a map from coordinates, right? So generate a map from location string, you know, as an example, New York City. All right, so I'm going to try this. I'm going to say, as this is going, I'm going to say generate a map from Chicago, Illinois. Let's see this plugin in work. So sometimes you have to tell ChatGPT to use this specific plugin. Sometimes you don't. So in this case, I didn't have to. It got it. And there we go. There's our plugin. Cool, right? All right. This is literally the most basic overview of plugins. And again, we do a lot of work on this. So you'll see now that I started the chat, I no longer have that option up here. So if I wanted different plugins, or I would click out and go to a different chat, or just start a new chat, and then I can, again, go and add and remove plugins. So a couple things to keep in mind. All plugins are free to install, right? But many of the plugins in here connect to a third-party service. So this one did not. But, you know, as an example, let's go ahead and look here. As an example, Zapier is one of my favorite plugins. I did a whole 40-minute episode on the Zapier plugin. Okay, so you have to have a Zapier account. And to do a lot of what the Zapier plugin is capable of, you also have to have a paid Zapier account. So keep that in mind. Many plugins require a third party account, and many of them also require you to have a paid account with that third party. All right, I hope this was helpful. Just a very, very basic overview of ChatGPT plugins. If this is helpful, subscribe to this channel, but also go to youreverydayai.com. Sign up for the free daily newsletter. We have a podcast, a live stream where we bring great guests every single weekday, Monday through Friday at 7:30 a.m. Central Standard Time. Come join the conversation on LinkedIn, ask our guest questions, learn and grow together, and then you can actually leverage AI. All right. Hope to see you back for another AI in 5.